Welcome to the show.
Hi.
Now, Brennan, you had some comments to make about one of our guests in our first episode.
Yes.
It was by her moniker, Miss Izzy.
Oh, yes.
And you actually made a video of this and put it on YouTube. Now, I'm just going to play that video.
In fact, actually, the video was supposed to be like a fake news video. Yes, and basically, one of the things that popped in my head was the previous blogtv.sg program, which is on Miss Izzy. And yeah, the most prominent thing was actually her accent.
Okay, yeah, let's see what you have to say.
Very good morning and welcome to another edition of Brennan Said Go. Yesterday we had the first episode of blogtv.sg. Guests included Sarong Party Girl, Angela from Blur Sotong, and today's editor. Oh, it's not Sarong Party Girl, it's Miss Izzy. And you know, she came onto the show with an accent that we cannot identify. An accent she can identify whether it's a English accent, an Australian accent, or I don't know what, the Singapore accent aside, let's move on to today's news. According to China, North Korea did not apologize to nuclear tests. Do I have to say sorry for a bomb which I have just dropped? No, within my territory. Bus riders want improvement in bus services. Listen up, SBS. If you want us to pay more for our bus services, but not teach us how to raise our hands to flag the bus. Up, down, up, down, up, down. And remember, if you want political news and views from the blogosphere, go to gov.brennan.sg. That's all for me, Brennan, signing off.
Now, Brennan, that's your clip.
Yes.
Now, this show is all about response.
Yes.
Okay, so we're going to give Miss Izzy a chance to respond, because that's what it's all about. So, Izzy, why don't you come and join us, and you'll get your chance to shout back.
Hi.
Just to let you know, this is Brennan. That's
yes. What do you think of his comments about your accent?
I think they were... Well, my accent's not something I really think about all the time. It's just the way I speak, and it's the way I'm comfortable speaking. And I think if I were to think about my accent, right, while I'm on TV, because I might alienate some of the audiences, then I wouldn't really be able to concentrate on the questions that you guys are asking me.
Sure.
And already, you know, it's like when you ask a very difficult question, it's kind of slightly on the personal side. Like, why are you putting these photographs of yourself, which are quite risque on the internet? You know, already I'm like, oh my God, I have to think of something. And the last thing that is on my mind is the way I speak, and I'll speak how I normally speak. So, you know, I don't see why anyone should have a problem with that.
So, Brennan, you got all that?
Yes, I got all that. Sometimes I find that, well, when it comes to accent, sometimes it's natural, sometimes it's unnatural.
How do you decide whether it's natural or unnatural?
Well,
is my accent natural or unnatural?
Well,
it's natural because you're unknown, you see. See,
I'm That's the point I'm driving at.
I have a friend who's living in the US. He told me that when he's living in the US, there are some people who have accent and there are some people who don't have the accent.
Mm-hmm.
Asians who are living in the US.
Right.
And what I found was that some of them, they actually just choose to have the accent. It's actually a choice.
It's not actually a choice, I can tell you. Because I also can speak like that.
Oh,
if I want to. But when I go, I have family in Australia. And after spending 2 weeks in Australia, I develop an Australian accent. Okay. Some people are like that. When you are around a certain group of people, you develop that accent. So it is natural to a point.
At the risk of, you know, possibly putting words in your mouth, I have the sensation that you were suggesting that her accent was fake.
Yes.
Right, like I said, normally I speak like this, so this is my normal way of speaking. Now, I don't know on that day how I spoke, but I was a bit nervous because I hadn't been on TV for a while, and I was a bit nervous, so that always causes me to, like, my brain to go a bit wonky, and I might speak not as natural, but this is how I speak naturally. So if you have a problem with this, then, you know, I don't know what to say. I think the most important thing is that people out there understand what I'm saying, what everyone is saying here, and it doesn't matter if you have an accent or not, if you really speak in a English in a drawling way, you know, if you speak like that, you know, if people understand, then great, you know, if they don't, then, well, then you have a problem, I suppose, but I have the sensation that most people understand me, so, you know, I don't see why you should have a problem with it, or why anyone should.
Well, I'm not having a problem with the accent or whatever, just mocking at the accent, that's all.
Mocking the accent?
Well, entertainment.